Please be seated. Good morning, the Church of the Resurrection. Welcome to this special service for Black History Month. I want to first make the announcement that Theron phoned last night about 9 o'clock to say he has COVID. So you'll be glad to know he's not here. In his place, who came to our rescue, is Elena Capillaris, right there in the front row. And who always comes for to my rescue, at least, Stacey McGregor on piano. So we have some things for you this morning, some planned, some unplanned, and we're just delighted that you're all here with us. There's a couple of things. In the narthex, somebody asked me what's a narthex once. It's that thing out there. There's a sign up for you to place notes for things for which you are grateful, and I'd encourage you to do that. There's also a sign-up sheet. If you missed the taking the photographs for the parish photo directory, there's still one opportunity to do that, and you can sign up out there. Yes?
I just wanted to thank everyone for their generous offerings of food for the food bank. And last week we got 132 pounds of baby things, which I thought was amazing. And to date we have 335 pounds of food collected. And next week we're going to get canned goods. So if you could remember that, but thank you, you've been so generous. Thank you so much.
Are we done? Well, let's take a moment for quiet reflection. You can remain seated for the first hymn. Elena and Stacy and I are going to look after that.
Please stand as you're able. Jesus was led into the wilderness by your Spirit, that he might emerge to fulfill his mission.
Lead us by your Spirit.
Nicodemus was challenged to be born again by your Spirit.
Fill us with your Spirit.
The Samaritan woman was offered living water when she came to the well where Jesus sat.
Satisfy our thirst through your Spirit.
The man born blind was freed from guilt and despair by the touch of Jesus.
Heal us through your Spirit.
Lazarus died but found new life in the power of Jesus' words.
Raise us by your Spirit.
Compassionate God, who sent Jesus the Christ to deliver us from all manner of injustices and inequalities, create in us new hearts and enlarged visions to see the image of God in every person, irrespective of background, race, and ethnicity. May we be generous in our love of others as we work towards ending misunderstanding, racism, and injustice, creating communities of human flourishing through Jesus, your Son, O Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and always.
Amen.
Racism, at the root, an issue of power, the limiting of the capacity of certain people and groups to act while privileging and promoting the capacity of others, solely on the grounds of racial characterization. Our worship and the life of the church are not free from these dynamics. This month and always, we are invited to develop a constant awareness to such dynamics in our worship and the life of the church, nourished by and borne out of the constant focus of true worship. At the heart of this invitation is an intentional focus on the attention to God and God's will for all people, life in all its fullness, according to the image of God in which all are created. God, you are good and upright, and you instruct sinners in your ways. Show us how to break down the barriers separating us from each other. Forgive us for the ways we exclude people of different race, culture, or gender. Guide us that we may come to mutual understanding and care.
Lead us through the wilderness,
sin, and Draw us into your community to embrace those with whom we need to be reconciled. Grant that all who seek to heal divisions between people may have hope.
Lead us through the wilderness, sin has created, to find new love.
Show us your ways, O Lord. Teach us your path and guide us towards your truth.
Lead us through the wilderness, sin has created, to find new life.
God looks upon our failings with mercy and with unending mercy. Grant us forgiveness and a new start as we seek to follow in the footsteps of Christ. Accept that mercy and fresh beginning in the name of the one who created us, who walk among us, and who call us to faithfulness.
Amen.
Having made our peace through Christ, let us share the peace with one another.
A reading from the book of Genesis. When Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to Abram and said to him, I am God Almighty. Walk before me and be blameless. And I will make my covenant between me and you and will make you exceedingly numerous. Then Abram fell on his face, and God said to him, As for me, this is my covenant with you. You shall be the ancestor of a multitude of nations. No longer shall your name be Abram, but your name shall be Abraham, for I have made you the ancestor of a multitude of nations. I will make you exceedingly fruitful, and I will make nations of you, and kings shall come from you. And I shall establish my covenant between me and you and your offspring after you throughout their generations for an everlasting covenant, to be God to you and to your offspring after you. God said to Abraham, As for Sarah, your wife, you shall not call her Sarah, but Sarah shall be her name. I will bless her, and moreover, I will give you a son by her. I will bless her, and she shall give rise to nations. Kings of peoples shall come from her. Holy word, holy wisdom. Thanks be to God.
God shall get, them that's not shall lose. So the Bible says, and it still is news. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own. God is own. Yes, the strong, they get more, while the weak ones fade. Empty pockets don't ever make the grade. Mama may have, child who's got his own, who's got his own. Money you've got, lots of friends crowded round your door, but and all the spending ends, they don't come around no more. Rich relations make it, crust of bread and such. You can help yourself, but don't take too much. Mama may, God bless the child who's got his own, who's got his own. Thank you.
sign for the gospel.
Or sit.
Okay.
I'm shocked it went so well at rehearsal. God is with you.
So with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Then Jesus began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days, rise again. He said this all quite openly. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan. For you are setting your mind on divine things, not on human things." He called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what then can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this wicked and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Creator with the holy angels." The Gospel of Christ. May the words of my lips and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in God's sight, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Well, it wasn't just Tyrone that kept me up last night. This gospel has been at me for a week or two. And it is partly the context for the gospel, because for Black History Month, you might want something that's just going to be a positive, love your neighbor and get on with it kind of gospel. Like the tune I picked that we're not going to sing, it's called Sermonette. We have played it before. I'd heard you a sermonette. Have you heard it yet? Yeah, I don't get excited. We're not doing it. It's a message that says, love your neighbor. And that's the message God wants us to hear. This gospel's a little more complex and maybe a little bit scary, even. A couple of things to note. One is that Son of Man means roughly humanity. Not Messiah, necessarily. That's a different thing. Jesus is saying, roughly, humans will suffer and die in order to rise again. Well, there's a phrase that will get the money coming into the church, isn't it? You have to suffer and die, and then through dying, rise again. And that progression is our salvation. And it's addressed to all of us. Now, some people talk about this gospel and say, well, Peter was disappointed because he wanted Jesus to be the Messiah, and the Messiah is the one who's going to come, like your next director, is going to come and fix everything. Solve all the problems of the world and bring in the kingdom. It's right there in the job description. So some people think that's what Peter is upset about. But it's actually even deeper and more personal than that.
Because Jesus said, the Son of Man. That means you and me. All of us. Everyone. All of us. And somehow that all of us will go through this progression will be the path to eternal life. There's conversation about shaming in that passage. And quite ironically, Jesus says to Peter, you're confusing divine and human things, when it sounds like that's exactly what Jesus is doing. Jesus has brought the divine to the human level. There's talk about shaming in that passage, and that for me is my segue to a conversation, another one, about Black history. I want to share you stories about two doctors in the town of Dundas. I'm sharing those stories because that's where I spend a good bit of my time, and I have a sort of arbitrary connection with at least one of these doctors. In that context, have you noticed that we've started tearing down statues of people that we thought were famous and good, and have discovered that they maybe don't meet the 20th century mark, and so their statue comes down? First doctor, Sir William Osler, Sir knighted William Osler, grew up in good old Dundas. His father was the first rector of the church where I served for 17 years. His father's name was Featherstone Lake Osler. Yeah. There's a big plaque for him in the church. Clergy tend to hang out for a long time at St. James, so he was there in the 1830s, and I was there not too long ago, and I was only the 13th rector of the place. Featherstone Lake Osler had four boys, one of whom was Sir William Osler, after whom a school in Dundas is now named, and who lived in a house that McMaster University bought recently. Now, Sir William Osler has been referred to as the father of modern medicine, and part of the reason for that is that he had a wonderful, wonderful diagnostic technique which he taught to medical students. He said, you actually need to eyeball them and talk to them before you diagnose. Revolutionary concept of medicine brought to us by the father of modern medicine, Sir William Osler. Here's the thing. Sir William was also wont to make bad, racist jokes. In one remark, under a pseudonym, when there are many people coming to this part of the world from India, he asserts that Canada should be white. Sir William did. Now, this revelation has prompted McMaster to try and divest themselves of the house they bought where he lived in Dundas. So far, no word on the school. It's still Sir William Osler School. But isn't it telling that we are apt to look at our historical figures through our 20th century eyes, as someone pointed out to me in the Detour Cafe this week, and interpret their lives through 20th century eyes. Second doc. Didn't know about this doc until quite recently. His name is Abbott. Mr. Abbott was a doctor in Dundas. The Historical Society, despite a ton of other evidence, finally allowed us how, yeah, this guy, oh, by the way, black. This guy is a doc for sure, because you know why? They have a record that he wrote a prescription. Now we know he was a doc. studied at Trinity College in Toronto, went to Oxford, as Sir William Osler did, was a good friend of Lincoln, fought in the Union Army in the Civil War, and when Lincoln was shot, he was one of the doctors who attended Lincoln's dying, Mr. Dr. Abbott. Lincoln's wife sent him a shawl that Lincoln loved, which he kept. There is no Abbott Street in Dundas. And we only find out about Abbott recently because of our recent interest in Black history and what's happening. Now, you might want to look back on these two doctors and begin to form judgments. And I'm here to tell you that you may be in danger of a rebuke in forming judgments about them, for a couple of reasons, not the least of which is that Jesus pointed out to us our common humanity. Every one of us is born to die. Every one of us. Black, white. Every one of us is born. And that, for Jesus, is the salvation story. That's how eternal life comes, when every heart joins every heart and sings in harmony. That's when we'll be free. The second thing about all of this is a wise spiritual director once said to me when I was going on about people who annoy me. None of them parishioners. I was having a good old therapeutic rant. And the spiritual director said to me, "You know why we get angry at the people who annoy us?" And I went, "No, but I have a feeling you're going to tell me." She said, "It's because they stir in us the parts of ourselves that we don't like." So you can rest assured, if you're annoying me, it's because I don't like myself about you. This makes sense? It's a wonderful, wonderful, and for Black History Month, perhaps a lesson to learn, which I believe is in the gospel, that when people tick us off, there's a learning to be had about ourselves in the process. And that Jesus refers to as taking up the cross and following him. When we do, we'll be free. Thanks for listening. I hope you enjoy today's service and the music. And I'm very grateful to this congregation for inviting this kind of venue for us to do this bit of history. Thanks for listening. Amen.
We continue in worship with the affirmation of faith printed in your bulletin. Mark by a cross, cherished and forgiven.
We are traveling home.
Called to be holy, called to be happy.
We are traveling home.
Across deserts, over mountains.
We are traveling home.
God in our hearts, God in our lives.
We are traveling home.
As is your preference, I invite you to pray in peace to Jesus our Lord, whoever lives to make intercession for us, saying, God of love, hear our prayer. God of all peoples, whose Son reached across the ethnic boundaries between Samaritan, Roman, and Jew, help us to break down the barriers in our communities. Enable us to see the reality of racism and bigotry, and free us to challenge and uproot it from ourselves, our society, and our world. God of love,
hear our prayer.
Savior of the world, be present in all places of suffering, violence, and pain. Thinking particularly of Israel and Palestine and Ukraine, and bring hope even in the darkest night. Inspire us to continue your work of reconciliation today. God of love, hear our prayer. Lord of the Church, empower by your Spirit all Christian people, particularly Leon and I, Nell Burke, Reginald and Irma Burke, and Susan Burke, and their families. We pray for our clergy and staff, and the people of this parish, and all who regularly use this building. In our diocese, we pray for Bishop Susan, and for St. Columba, St. Catherine's, the Reverend William Alacas, rector, and the people of that parish. We pray for the work of your church in every land. Give us grace to proclaim the gospel joyfully in word and deed. God of love.
Amen.
Shepherd and guardian of our souls, guide and enable all who lead and serve this country, province, and city, and those on whom we depend for our daily needs. Watch over our veterans, and the current members of the Canadian Forces, Rangers, and Cadets, and enable them to continue to serve their country with integrity, honor, and compassion, here and in missions abroad. Grant that we all may seek the peace and welfare of our world. God of love. God of joy, we pray with thanksgiving for all who celebrate birthdays and anniversaries this week, particularly Brianna Gordon, Steve Swing, Barry Reese, and Cameron Buttram. God of love, hear our prayer. Great physician, stretch out your hand to bring comfort, wholeness, and peace to Frank, Albert, Fred, John, and Sylvia, Diane R., Mabel, Susan T., Millicent W., Dulcie, Kevin B., and Wayne L., and to all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, praying particularly for King Charles in his battle with cancer. Fill us with compassion, that we may be channels of your healing love. And here, as is our custom, I ask your prayers of concern, caring, and compassion, silently or aloud. Hear our prayer.
Prayers for Tyrone and his recovery from COVID. God, in your love.
Hear our prayer. God of love, hear our prayer. Conqueror of death, we lift before you those who have gone before us, particularly the husband of Lena Marie Neal, who died earlier this week. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May his soul and the souls of all the departed through the mercy of God rest in peace and rise in glory. We pray for comfort for Lena Marie and those who mourn and remember. The flowers this week are given by the Salonen and Martin families in loving memory of father and grandparents, James, Harry, and Beatrice Jervis, who taught them faith, community, and love. God of love. Come, all who are thirsty, says Jesus our Lord. Come, all who are weak. Taste the living water that I shall give. Dip your hands in the stream. Refresh body and soul. Drink from it. Depend on it. For this water will never run dry. Come, all who are thirsty, says Jesus our Lord. Amen.
You can feel free to sing along if you want.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to feel, and grace my fears relieved. How precious grace, that grace did appear the hour I first
Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for the gift of bread and wine. May they continue to nourish and strengthen us as we continue our earthly journey. Amen. May God be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to God.
Let us give thanks to our loving God. In Christ, your Son, our life and yours are brought together in a wonderful exchange. He made his home among us that we might forever dwell in you.
Through your Holy Spirit, you call us to new birth, and creation restored by God.
As children of your redeeming purpose, we offer you our praise with angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, saying the hymn of your unending glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We thank you, Lord our God, for this world which you have given us. You never cease to make it new, and you call us to work with you. You accept the work of our hands. You have made humankind in your image. Each one of us is fashioned in your likeness, and we are able to recognize your face in the faces of our brothers and sisters. You have never desired to live apart from us, and you have taught us to know you through the law and the prophets, the apostles and evangelists, who told us the marvelous story of your love. And you have come to us in your Son, Jesus the Christ. In him you have walked along our roads. Look at us with human eyes. Done the kind of things that we do. And share with us the joy that can never be lost. On the night he was betrayed, your Son Jesus Christ took bread, blessed, broke, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body. It is broken for you." Likewise, he also took the cup, offered you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." Now you give us his body and blood, and we give ourselves to you. Through the death and resurrection of your Son, through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us, we can make you our eternal home. Let us pray as Christ has taught us, in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Made one in Christ and one with each other, we offer these gifts and with them a single living act of praise. Here at this table, Jesus is host. Come to this table. It is Christ who invites us and Christ who meets us here. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Let us pray. Let us pray. All your works praise you, O God.
And your faithful servants bless you. Gracious God, we thank you for leading us the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. May we who share his body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We who share lives give life to the world. Give us firm in the hope you have set before us, so that we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We've met and decided that we're going to do Hymn to Freedom. Thank you. Then after the blessing, we're going to do Just a Closer Walk with Thee. And for Hymn to Freedom, you're invited to join in as you see fit or are excited. So let's stand.
May we find the road that leads to life. May we take the turns that bring bright relationships. May we pause to accompany others on the way. And may we journey with God through Lent and long for the horizon at dawn. Amen.
Congratulations to Nancy and all friends who did the coldest night of the year walk in. Well done, you. Give it up for Elena Capilleras, Stacy McGregor, and the usual suspect on there. We're going to play a tune. You're welcome to join, go for coffee, take a walk, whatever you like.
Closer walk with me.